What's going on, Clash Royale viewers? I feel like our relationship, I know that's weird to say, our relationship has reached a point because most of you are fairly new subscribers. You don't know this type of chase, but you're about to see this type of chase where we have a heart-to-heart discussion about a topic that no YouTuber is discussing right now. It is whether Clash Royale is pay to win or free to play and what that means for us, the players. I've done this many times with other games. It's time to bring it to Clash Royale. The moment is right now. We have to discuss this. And please share your comments down below. Let me know whether you agree or disagree with me. Just let me know what your opinion is. So let's talk about what free to play and pay to win actually means. The definition seems simple, but it's really not. In fact, I went to this video game conference earlier this year called PAX. And one of the things they did there, they had this mega convention, this Q&A with these huge developers. And the topic was free to play versus pay to win. And you had all these big fat nerds with these big laughs, and they're like, "Oh, we hate you developers for making games pay to win. Oh, I'm gonna kill myself." These guys were pissed. And the developers were up there trying to defend this model of pay to win. Let's talk about what it means. Free to play means I can obtain everything in the game by playing for free. Pay to win means if I pay, I get items, characteristics, perks, whatever you want to call it, not available to the unpaid players that give me an unfair advantage. Let me word it another way. The pay to win means I win because I pay. I don't win because I have skill. So Clash Royale has a very fine line, and I feel like they've crossed it. You know where this discussion is going. I'm already leaking my opinion, but let's start from the beginning. Remember when you first downloaded Clash Royale, it popped a warning. It said, "This is a free-to-play game, but you can pay to speed up the progress." Now, back then, things were very different than they are today. There was only two legendary cars, Princess and Ice Wizard. Also, the level caps for friendly play and tournament play was much lower. Your kings were capped at level 8, your commons level 8, your epics level 3, your legendaries level 1. Now, today, four new legendary cards, higher cap levels, level 9 for your kings, and crown towers, higher level for the epics, I think it's 4 or 5, higher level for the commons at 9, everything got moved up 1 or 2 card levels. Now I'm gonna get real down to earth. I've spent $360 on the game. All my cards I have are not at the cap level for tournament or friendly play. That means I can't compete at the same level, right? Now some of you may say, "Well, I do fine chase, I do fine in friendly play, I do fine in tournament play as a free to play player." I guarantee you, if you're a free-to-play player, you've been playing with the same deck for 6 freaking months. How annoying is that? How annoying is that? Because I have spent $360 and I still don't have my cards to the level caps for friendly play. Now, Supercell sold us some song and dance. They said, "No, guys, we're moving the level caps up to have a more balanced gameplay." Bull crap. Bull crap. It was to bring in more money, because when you start losing to your friends and your clan, you start losing in tournament play, guess what you want to do? That competitive nature of humans takes over, and you want to spend money to level up your cards to get to those level caps so you can compete. And mark my words, I guarantee you down the road, the level cap for King will be 10. They'll continue to increase that as free-to-play players get closer to the level caps. Let's talk about legendary cards. These cards are freaking impossible to get. If you're lucky enough to get to the Legendary Arena as a free-to-play player, you have to wait for it to show up in the shop. Which, by the way, the drop rate in the shop is like next to zero. And when it does show up in the shop, it costs 40,000 gold, which is the equivalent of about $25 to $30 to get one legendary card. Now, these legendary cards are overpowered, and I think they're impossible to get. I've spent $360. I have one legendary card. And if you have these legendary cards, you have a completely unfair advantage, which is the definition of pay to win. In fact, lately, the decks I'm running up against are guaranteed running 2, if not 3, legendary cards. We're talking Minor Princess Ice Wizard decks. We're talking Sparky Archer, Sparky Princess Ice Wizard decks. These type of decks, right? The Minor, all this stuff. There's 6 legendary cards. They're really focusing on legendary cards because they're overpowered and they know that's where they're going to get their money. People are going to spend so much money on chess and on gold to try to get these legendary cards. Now up at the top, the guys at the top, these guys have spent tens of thousands of dollars to max out their legendary cards, which I think the cap is 5, plus their commons at level 13. Tens of thousands of dollars. And you guys watch a lot of these big YouTubers because they have these cards at such high level. I'll never be there because I can't see myself spending that much money on a game. So has Supercell crossed the line that we have to spend tens of thousands of dollars to be able to compete, or if we compete at the level caps in tournament play, we have to spend thousands of dollars. Hundreds of dollars doesn't get us to a place where we compete anymore. Like, are you kidding me? I could spend hundreds of dollars on a game, and I can't compete. Unless I want to play with the same stupid deck my whole life, which gets really boring. Part of the fun of this game is creating new decks, mixing cards up. But you can't do that when you can't level up your cards, and it becomes harder and harder to level up the cards. That's my opinion. I feel that in the beginning, Clash Royale was truly a free-to-play game. But now with the recent changes, the level caps moving up for friendly play, the additional legendary cards that are nearly impossible to get, it's pay to win. I don't know how to call it anything else what it is, but I digress. And by the way, this is a one take. I'm not editing anything. This is one take. This is just me talking to you from my heart. Does it make the game less fun? Let me know down below. I'm curious what you think. Does the fact that this game, let's assume that I'm right, that this is pay to win. Does the fact that it's pay to win make it less fun? Does the fact that it's pay to win mean I'm going to delete the game? Absolutely not. Supercell are geniuses. This is an amazing game. And they make you feel good about spending money. I don't know how they do it. They're geniuses. They make you feel good about spending money. Never have I felt good about spending money in a game until Clash Royale. So I love the game, even though it's pay to win. I love the game. I love the grind. I love everything about it. It just keeps bringing you back again, again, and again. That's my opinion. Let me know if you feel differently down below. And I love the whole currency system. You got gems. You got coins. They don't shove it in your face, advertising all over the place. You know they're there, and you know you can go to it at any time, and they know they're going to break you down because we all have a competitive spirit deep within us. Thanks for listening to my little rant. Yes, I do think Clash Royale is pay to win. Let me know if you agree, disagree in the comments, and we'll see you guys in the next Clash Royale video. Take care.